Hi friends, welcome back to the course. So recently I received a question in one of my videos asking me what is the difference between an alloy and a composite. So I thought I will make a video to address this particular question. So let's start off talking about alloys. So basically alloys are composed of one or more chemical elements. Same like composites, but the key difference comes in here. In the case of alloys, one among the two should be a metal. So this kind sort of a constraint is not there in composites. So you take any alloy, for example, if you consider steel as an example, then it's an alloy of iron and carbon. Obviously, in steel, the amount of carbon is restricted. As we can see here, iron is a metal, but carbon is a non-metal, but fine. The criteria is satisfied. You take another alloy, like, let's say, bronze. Bronze is an alloy of copper and tin. In this case, again, at least one among them is a metal. So that criteria is again satisfied. The same applies for brass also, which is an alloy of copper and zinc. Mostly the other thing is, here the crystal structure is maintained. When you add carbon to iron, what happens is, the crystal structure won't undergo much of a change. The moment you add carbon, what will happen is, this carbon atoms, these relatively smaller in size carbon atoms will occupy interstitial positions like this. Here, all these things which you can see here, these are all iron atoms. Then this dark colored carbon atoms will occupy the interstitial space inside the crystal structure. So they won't alter the crystal structure and all other related properties by a great deal. Moreover, a few more things. There is no chemical bonding. That is the one key difference between a compound and alloy. There is no particular chemical formula for steel, but you have a unique chemical formula for H2O. The reason for that being, in a compound, hydrogen and oxygen are bonded together using either an ionic or a covalent or some kind of chemical bonding is there in between. That sort of a chemical bonding is completely absent in an alloy. Moreover, alloys can be of single phase as well as multi-phase. For an example, take a lead in copper alloy. So the figure here corresponds to an electron micrograph of a particular lead in copper alloy. So in this figure, you can clearly identify two different phases. The first phase, mainly the background, the white background which you see the grain boundaries here. The white background represents the phase of lead in copper as a solid solution. Now, the dark particles which are uniformly distributed across this phase, they corresponds to a second phase of lead. They are basically lead particles distributed throughout the microstructure. So there are single phase alloys as well. If you take a steel alloy in which carbon content is less than 0.022 weight percentage, then it is a single phase alloy, iron carbon alloy. The only phase present in that particular alloy is ferrite. So these are the few things which I would like to tell you about alloys. Now let's start talking about composites and identify what are the key differences when it comes to composite on how it is different from alloys. Let's have a look at that. Broadly speaking, composite is any multi-phase material that that exhibits better combination of properties compared to its constituent phases. Okay, but the key difference is here there is no particular restriction saying that one phase should be metal. There is no restriction like that. You have different kind of composite. You have metal matrix composites, you have polymer matrix composites, you have whatnot. You have so many natural composites also. For example, wood is a good example for natural composite. In wood, let me show you the figure. In wood, as you can see here, there are strong flexible cellulose fibers as shown here. These are those very strong, but they are flexible, these cellulose fibers. But they are held together in a stiff lignin matrix, as you can see here. So the cellulose fibers are flexible, but you have a very stiff lignin matrix to hold them together, which effectively results in a better properties for the wood altogether. Moving to the next example of a natural fiber, it's human bone. Human bone is consisting of two main components, like a soft protein collagen in a very hard and brittle mineral apatite. I can show you a figure corresponding to this as well. So here we have our strong yet very soft that collagen fiber. It will be held together with a hard and brittle mineral called apatite. So these are the few composites which we find in nature. But when it comes to industries, leave away the natural composites. Structural composites or composites which are very widely used in industry, they can be classified or they can be defined like this. They corresponds to any multi-phase material that is artificially made, where the different phases are chemically distinct, and these two distinct phases should be separated by a distinct interface. For an example, here is the very famous carbon fiber reinforced plastic. Here you can see the fibers like this, and here you can see the matrix. See, this is a particular multi-phase material which we made artificially. When you just put fibers and matrix together, it didn't automatically take this particular configuration. But in the case of alloys, I didn't do much. When I added lead to copper, automatically it resulted in a multi-phase system. But when it comes to composite, when it comes to CFRP, I had to make this small glass fibers, and then I had to put them in this polymer matrix in order to get a carbon fiber reinforced plastic. In a nutshell, let's conclude whatever we have discussed. So these are the key differences between alloys and composite. The first one, in alloys there is a clear distinction or a clear requirement that at least one name of the component should be a metal, and no such restriction exists in composites. The second difference is that alloys can be of either single phase or multi-phase. I told you, and steel alloy where only ferrite phase exists, and a steel alloy where perlite microstructure exists, where there are two different phases. And I have also shown you an example of lead and copper alloy where two phases exist. But when it comes to composite, there is no single phase composite. Always composites are multi-phase. Referring to the same example, the CFRP example, the fiber is a particular phase and the polymer matrix is another phase. They are physically distinct, they are different in their physical makeup, they are different in their chemical makeup also. The last difference among these two, in one case, especially in alloys, the multi-phase is generated naturally, but in composites, it is not generated naturally. We are intentionally mixing these two phases together to produce the composite. So I hope this particular video clears or clearly tells you what are the key differences between alloys and composites. Thanks for watching.